Hello everybody, my name is Octavian Nadolu, and in this morning I will talk about JSON and JSON Schema. So JSON started to be used a lot with XML, and our XML users started to want also support for JSON similar as for XML. They will not get it, but they will get some parts of this support. So we started to add support to edit JSON, to validate against the JSON schema, and I will present some of these features that we have and some of the features that we added in the current version for JSON. So this is the agenda of the presentation. We'll discuss about JSON and JSON schema, about validating JSON with Schematron, which is an interesting approach, about converting JSON to XML and back, and also generating a JSON schema from XSD. For example, if you have an XSD schema and you want to have a similar API for JSON, you could do this by converting this XSD to JSON schema. Also, we have an instance generator that we added in the current version, and also we added support to somehow generate a JSON schema from an instance, like a learning support. And this helps you if you start using JSON and you don't have a JSON schema, you can generate one and then start to add different properties or add different constraints on your JSON schema. So, as I told you, JSON is used a lot with APIs, and it's used a lot in JavaScript environment because it's easier to read and write, so people are using JSON in that part. The JSON structure, it's simple. You have these property values. It's not something very complicated. And then you have object and arrays that groups different properties, and array that groups different values of JSON documents. Let's discuss about validating JSON documents. So, first of all, you can check if a JSON document is conforming to the JSON definition, JSON structure. So you can check if it's all formed. Then you can use a JSON schema and validate a JSON using a JSON schema and check if it conforms to your specification. And you can also check if a JSON schema is valid conform to the specification of the JSON schema. The JSON structure looks something like this. So here we have a simple object with some property values, and you can find here a link to the JSON website, and this is the specification ECMA 404 for the JSON standard. And this defines how the JSON structure should look like, and if you want to check if a JSON document is well-formed, you need to check if it's conformed to these definitions. And for example, you need to have a column after a property, otherwise will not be valid, or you need to have a comma after a value, or if you have here a comma that is not allowed after an object, it will show you an error. Or if you have missing codes, then this is also an well-formed problem in JSON. It's similar with what we have for XML. So I will show you a simple example. I have here a JSON document. And for example, if I delete a comma from here, it automatically pop up an error, and it will say that here it expects either a colon, a comma, or a bracket. So you get these problems if you are not writing correctly the JSON documents. Then we have the JSON schema. The JSON schema, it's similar with XSD, DTD, but it's different. It's created for JSON documents and to define the structure of the JSON documents, and can be used to validate, but also used for content completion, for example, for JSON documents. So the JSON schema is written in JSON, and it's the same idea as the XML schema or RelaxNG schema. And it's used to define the structure. Here we have a simple schema that says the type of the JSON document should be a string. And then the JSON instance must be something like this, a simple string. If you define an object, then things get more complicated. If you say here that the type of the instance should be an object, then inside you can define the properties and so on. You can create a complex JSON document. The JSON schema has also a definition. So when you create a JSON schema, you need to have this schema defined on the first level. I'll show you right away how a JSON schema looks like. So something like this. So on the first level, you need to have this definition. This means that the JSON document is a JSON schema. This defines that this JSON document is a JSON schema, otherwise you cannot detect this JSON document cannot be detected as a JSON schema. So here, in this definition, you have also the version of the JSON schema. We see here that for my definition, I have draft 07. There are a few drafts available of JSON schema from 1 to 7, and last year was released also 8. We have support for draft 4, that is the most used, and then is draft 6 and draft 7 that are also used in this part for validation. We didn't add yet support for draft 8. So, in order to have a JSON schema, you need to have this definition. Otherwise, you need to specify somehow that this JSON document is a JSON schema. And in Oxygen, you can do this from a validation scenario. You can configure a validation scenario. And you can say that you want to validate this JSON schema with a JSON schema validator. And this will automatically set this JSON document as a JSON schema. Then you can also associate a JSON document with a JSON schema with a JSON document, and it's a similar definition as you have for JSON schema. You can associate the URL of the JSON schema in the JSON instance, and I can show you a simple example here. So I can use this action that will allow me to select an URL, and then I can use a relative path or an absolute path, and this will set this JSON schema here on the first level, and this JSON schema will be used for validation and for content completion. It will present me the problems from this schema. For example, here it found that a require given property is defined in the JSON schema and is not added in my document. Then you need to validate also a JSON schema. And there's a specification. As I told you, there are a few versions of the JSON schema. And you need to check the JSON schema according to the specification, to the IETF specification. And we have support, as I told you, for JSON schema draft 4, draft 6, and draft 7. And we automatically detect from the definition of the schema what version it is, and it will validate against that draft. Of course, you can also check if it's well formed as a JSON document. Then another interesting feature that we added in this version is to validate JSON against Schematron. So JSON defines a structure. And this structure can be also mapped to an XML structure. So you could have like a parser that will provide you a source, an XML source over the JSON document, and then validate it with the JSON, with the Schematron. And the only thing that you need to do back is to map the problems back into the JSON document. So when you parse the JSON document, you need to keep also the location of the properties to map them back. So a schematron for JSON is similar as you have for XML, and I will show you an example. Let me close these files. So this is a simple schematron file that checks different things from the JSON document, and it uses XPath. So it just uses XPath as for XML documents. And then if I validate, for example, this document against the schematron file, it will map the problems in the JSON document. It will say, for example, that the publishing, the birthday is not correct, and it should be before the publishing year. So I need to correct this, and then the problem will disappear. Or here, you need to have an order, for example, for all the properties from JSON. So in JSON schema, as in XML schema, you cannot add this type of constraints, like a property depend on another, and then with Schematron you can do such things, and you can add constraints like this one. Or here, for example, I have a book that has a gen that is not defined yet, and it's literary fiction, and these are defined in the document here. So if I add a new property with this type, then this problem will be gone. So you have different things that different rules that you can add with Schematron that will not be able to do it with other type of schema, like JSON schema. As I told you, in order to create this JSON these constraints for JSON documents, you need to use XPath expression. So you can look at the JSON document like an XML document and just type there the name of the properties that you want to check, and then use XPath to go up and down and add constraints to the properties. And these are mapped back in the document. Then let's discuss a little bit also about editing JSON documents. So we have support to edit JSON documents in text mode, and we have syntax highlight, content completion. We have also the grid editing mode. Then we have an outline view that will help you to see the structure of a JSON document, and this will show you the structure even if the document is not well formed. Then we have content completion based on JSON schema, and we have also documentation from JSON schema, and we can also associate JSON schema with JSON documents through the validation scenarios. So first, let me show you the text mode and the grid mode for JSON. Let me close these examples. So as you've seen, we have this syntax highlight for JSON documents, and you can edit here the JSON, and it will present you as you edit the syntax of the documents. But you can also switch to the grid mode if you want to have a tabular form. And this is useful, for example, if you want to move properties, move the link back and forward, or sort them somehow, or if you want to copy this data to an Excel, so you can switch to the grid mode and copy the data there. So you can also use this grid mode. Then we have this JSON outline view that is similar with the XML one, but it presents the properties, and it's synchronized with the editor. You have filtering. it presents you the errors also in the document. I will show you some examples. So if I make here an error, it will be presented here in the outline, and we notice that even if the document is not well formed, the outline will keep showing me the structure of the document. I can search to the structure of the document. I can filter. Let's say we search for email, and it will present me the email. Then you have also different actions that present them in a flat way or not. So this will help you to easy to see the structure of the documents. Next, we have also support to associate the schema. As you've seen, you can associate it in the document, but you can also use validation scenarios, and you can validate a batch of JSON files, of a project with JSON files against the JSON schema. So, let me try this example. So, I can create a validation scenario, for example, or I can use the validate with action to validate a JSON with a JSON schema, something like this, and it will present me the problems here. But I can also associate the JSON schema with the JSON document, and this will present me the errors as I type. So I can say that I want this JSON schema, and the file type JSON document is detected automatically, and then if I save, it will automatically show me the errors, and when I insert content, it will automatically fix the problems, will be automatically corrected. Here I need to use this comma. Then based on the associated JSON schema, you can also have content completion, and we have support to present the documentation of the JSON schema. And we provide also documentation for JSON schema and links to the specification. Show you an example also for this part. So if you want to insert, for example, a new item, when you insert an object, it will automatically insert the required content. So it detects the required content from the JSON schema, and it inserts it in the JSON document, and you just need to fill the data. And for this we have some options available in preferences. That will say that to generate the required content for content completion. You can also check if you want to generate the optional content or the additional content defined in the JSON schema. Then we also have documentation. So when you insert a property, for example, here, we notice that we have some documentation that is presented in the documentation window, and this is collected automatically from the JSON document. So if we go to the definition, we see that, for example, here we have an ID type, and for this type we have a title and a description, and this will be presented when you insert the content. So it will help you to understand what properties and what values you need to insert there. And also for JSON schema, you have editing support, and we have for most of the properties from the specification, we have documentation, and you have also link to the specification to take you to the JSON schema specification to check the what the property does. Then you can also query and transform JSON documents. And we added support to query JSON documents using XPath. It's based on the same mechanism that we have for Schematron. So we have parts of that converts the document to an XML format and use XPath to process them. Then you can also use XSLT and XQuery, and I will show you some example how to use XSLT and XQuery. So for XPath we have, as we have for the JSON, for XML we have this XPath toolbar that will allow you to insert an XPath expression, and we provide content completion based on the XPath document that it's on the JSON document that it's opened, and also functions that can be used in the current context. So if I go to this example, or maybe this one, but with books, I could type an XPath and I can say, okay, I want to get all the book or all the books, and automatically presents me the properties. And then from the book, I want to get, I don't know, a description. And if I run this, I'll get the description of all the books from my document. And you can run this on the current file, but you can also use a batch query and query all the files from a folder. For example, I can use XPath in files here and say definition, description, and then if I run it, I get all the description from this folder, of the books from this folder. So you can also use this support in order to query and get data from JSON documents. Then in order to transform a JSON document, we have support to transform it using XSLT and XQuery. XSLT 3.0 has support using JSON document to process a JSON document. And you can also convert to JSON to XML and run a transformation over a JSON document. And I made some simple examples here, just to show you how this works. So I have this XSL document that gets as input a JSON document. It's a parameter, and then uses the JSON doc function to process the JSON document and applies the templates. And here is just a simple template that will print all the data from the JSON document. I think I already have a scenario, and as parameters I have this books JSON file. And if I run it, it will generate an HTML file with all the data from that JSON document. But I can make it look better. For example, I can do something like this. I can create an HTML document, and then for each book from the JSON document, I can print the title and the author. And if I run this transformation, it looks a little bit better now. Have the title and the author. And I have a third step here. And this should look even better. So here I have also a table with the description and the images of the book. And it will just provide me an output, an HTML output like this. So you can process the JSON document using the JSON doc function and use XSLT to transform it. And for this, you just need to create a transformation scenario and provide as parameter the JSON document. And in the XSLT, use this XSL initial template to match, to process the document. I have an example also for X query. For example, this one. It also uses JSON document to process the JSON document, and from the books, I will select only the books with XML category, and then I will print in a JSON document, this time the author and the title. And I have a scenario created also for this document, for this XQuery that takes the books JSON as a document URI. As an output, it will save it, the result in a JSON document. And if I run it, it will give me the titles and the author of the XML books, and I can say that I want, for example, the XSL books, and then I'll get the XSL books very easily here. And of course, you can generate different output. You've seen that from XSL, I generated HTML. From XQuery, I generated JSON, but you can also have, for example, an XQuery that will generate XML. So you can generate everything you want. Then we have also some JSON tools that we added in this version. So users are asking for different tools to handle these JSON documents and provide APIs, for example, and they have XSD for XML APIs, and they want also XML schema, but they don't know how to generate a JSON schema and create them a similar JSON schema. So we try to provide them a conversion to start from, then an instance generator that will allow you to generate multiple instances with different data and test the JSON schema, and also support to generate a JSON schema from an instance. And let me start with the conversion. So we have support to convert JSON to XML and back. The JSON to XML, it's straightforward. So the property is converted to an element, and the property value is converted into children, and then it goes down to convert the rest, the property, and then the value, and so on. So it's not a complicated conversion. I can show you how you can do this in Oxygen. Let me close these files. Have here a JSON document with some books, and then I can use from tools. We have this menu with JSON tools in the tools menu, and I can say that I want to generate a JSON to XML and say result here. And we see that the converted result is open in the editor. And if we take a look, it looks something similar. So we have these books that it generated to a books element, and then the value of the book is generated as a book, and then so on. The value from here is generated inside the element. And we have also the conversion back. First, let me tell you a few things about this conversion. So in case you have multiple routes in JSON document, then a JSON route is added, a fake JSON route would be added in the JSON, in the resulted XML document, because otherwise the result will not be well formed. Then if you have arrays, then an array route will be added. And for each item of the array, if the array is not named, you could have a named array or unnamed array, as I have here, then an array item will be generated. So there are some things that are not straightforward, and we have them documented in our user manual to know them. But most of the conversion are like you've seen before, so the property goes into the element. Then for the XML to JSON conversion, here are more complex things. The conversion is similar, so the element will be converted to a property, and then the content of the element will be generated as value of that property, and then will go forward. And the difference here, for example, attributes will be converted to property value, so you'll not have an information that property was an attribute or an element when you come back. I will show you. So for this example, books result, I can generate a JSON document and can go to tools, also XML to JSON document, and I will select this generated XML, and I will generate a JSON from it. That will look something like this. So have also each element generated in a property, and then for each book we have an item in an array which has the properties that are defined in the book. So it's not a complicated conversion, but also here you have different things that you need to know, such as the attributes that will be converted to property values. And then if you have multiple elements of the same with the same name, then in JSON an array will be generated, as we had for the books. And then there is the problem with the mixed content that we handled like this. So for the first item, for the first text from a mixed content, we'll generate hash text property, and then we'll add an index for the next text that is added in the element, and then the index will go hash text 1, hash text 2, hash text how many texts are in the document. So we somehow handle also this mixed content when you, we generate JSON from XML. Then let's discuss about JSON to XML to JSON schema, XSD to JSON schema conversion. This is a it's a plugin. It will be installed automatically as you try to when you try to use it first time. It will require to install, and just need to follow some steps to install the plugin. And it will provide you an interface something like this. You provide the XSD and will generate a JSON schema. You don't have much options here. So there are a few things that you need to check maybe before you start using it, with the types, how they are converted. And we have here a mapping from XML schema to JSON schema to know how the types are mapped in the converted JSON document. I will show you an example. So have here the XSD to JSON schema, and I have an XSD file about a purchase order. This tool, you can find it in the JSON tools. I already installed it, so I'm not required to install it. So when you use it from here first time, it will pop up your dialog to install it, and you just need to click that and then next to install it. And here I can select the XSD schema, then it will generate a PO schema that was already created. And schema will look something like this. So it will have, in fact, the types that there are in the JSON schema, and it will define properties and definitions from the types from the XSD. For example, here I have a purchase order type, and the purchase order type has this ship to that is a US address and bill to that is a US address, and then the items, and each item is defined here, and it requires to have these values, the product name, the quantity, and then we have the properties. It somehow similar with the XSD definitions. Then we have an instance generator that will allow you to generate from a JSON schema instances, and we have different options to to generate random values, to generate choices or optional content. I can show you some example also for this conversion. So we can generate sample files. And I have this personal schema which defines some persons. It has a person type, and each person has an ID, a name, an email, and then a link. And I can use the instance generator to generate some instances. You can also find it in the JSON tools, and I can say JSON files, select the JSON schema. Then I can also associate the JSON schema with each document if I want to have it associated. I can specify the output folder here. By default is the current folder of the JSON schema. I think it works anyway. Then I can specify the name of the output, let's say person, and then the number of instances. You can generate as many as instances you want. Then here you can set if you want to use a default or a random value for the JSON property values. I'll use random. You could generate also the optional content. As you've seen in the JSON schema, you have these required properties, but if a property is not required, then it's optional. And you can also generate additional properties in JSON schema. You can define also some properties that can be added additional to your JSON property. Then if you have choices, you can set to use first or use random for the generated values, and have also a recursivity level here in case you have type that refers type and refers type. And I generate some instances and look something like this. So we'll generate a property personnel and then some person elements properties, and inside some the values that are for the person. And this is random generated, so has like a lot of information here and can be used to test different APIs, for example, with these values. Another interesting tool is to, 1 minute, yes, okay. I'm on time. So another interesting tool is to generate a JSON schema from a JSON instance. If you already have a JSON instance, or you open it and you want to create a JSON schema to add some constraints on it or have content completion, then you can use this tool. I think it's useful, and I will show you an example here. So I have this personnel file, and if I don't have a schema or I don't know how to create one, I can go to tools, JSON tools, and then use generate JSON schema. Here you just specify the file. It will automatically add a generated schema JSON. Then has some options. For example, extract matching format for strings. it will automatically detect if you are using emails, and it will generate a JSON schema with email format, or if you are using numbers or strings or other type of URIs, for example, it will set that the format for that property should be an URI. So this option, it will detect this, then you can add some automatically default values, or you can restrict additional content. It will generate from the JSON instance the exact content as it is, or it will allow you to somehow insert other content, but keep the current one required. It already exists, so I'll overwrite it. And this is the generated schema. We have these definitions, and for name, for example, it says that name should have a property and given. Then the link should have property subordinates. An email should have the type string but the format email, so it will automatically handle this type of problem. And then you can start working, maybe add other properties here, or maybe edit some of them. You can also find more details in our user manual about this generation. So, as a conclusion, JSON is a format that is used together with XML and has a specification, and in order to check if a JSON document is well formed and it's valid, you need to check this specification, and you can validate it with a JSON schema. But you can also use Schematron to validate JSON documents, to add co-constraints or different other type of rules that you cannot do it with JSON schema. You can also query and transform it with XSLT or use XPath to get data from JSON. And you have some tools that will allow you to start using it. Just generate a JSON schema from XSD, or generate a JSON schema from the instance, or generate sample files from a JSON schema. So you have different useful tools. So thank you. If you have questions about this part, I'll be happy to answer them. Yes?
I think you forgot actually to mention one very useful thing in Oxygen, which is the pretty print for JSON. Because usually when you query your REST interface, you get JSON back. It's just one big, enormous string. Then just pressing Ctrl Shift B.
Yes. This is true. I didn't add all the features from here from Oxygen. I just mentioned some of them because there are a lot also for JSON. But
I know, but that was is very useful. Yeah. To
nice to hear. Yes.
When you convert JSON to XML, sometimes get elements like array and match. Are there an issue when you come to write the next tag, or when you write Schematron, do you have to deal with those, or are you hiding them so you don't have to remember or know where they are?
Usually for this conversion, we hide everything, so you don't know what happens behind. So you just need to type an XPath expression, and you need to think as the JSON document is an XML, so just go like select an element, and then if you want to select these children.
That's great.
Yeah. And we somehow add on this conversion, we just keep the location of the original properties, and we know to map them back when we select the content. Other questions? No. Thank you.